Good morning, everybody. Okay, somebody on this couch is beaming. It is. Fresh off their win, we welcome Stephen Moores. You made headlines because a dream came true for you, and we finally got to see it on Monday. Talk to us about your love for all things Price is Right.
I've been watching it since I was a kid. You know, my dad went to the show 43 years ago, got to go down. He never got called up, but he had a really great time at the show, and, you know, so... You know, that sort of instilled to me The Price is Right. You know, as a kid, when you're home from school sick, you know, you always turned on The Price is Right. So I've just always had a fascination with that. And, you know, our family is big game show enthusiasts. And,
you are enthusiastic. You're not just a big game show enthusiast. You're enthusiastic. Watch this when you're...
Yes!
Now, did you practice that dance beforehand?
No, that's just me. I'm just the life of the party. I have a great time. And, you know, it was just... a lifelong dream coming true. Like, you just can't believe it.
And what I love is you didn't just say, you know, I'm going to go see if I can get on the show. You actually thought about how to get on the show.
Oh, yeah. I spent some time looking into it, looking at YouTube videos, following the producers sort of peak. You know, Michelle, my girlfriend, made some really great shirts for us. So we had it all planned out, and we're hopeful, you know. We always wanted to get up there, and it was my time.
Planko, baby! By the way, we'll test this later. She said it glows in the dark. She's here today. So it kind of looked like things weren't going well for you. You had a minute. You didn't play the checkout game very well. You thought you were done. You came back, right?
Yeah, and, you know, it's the big wheel, you know. You just never know what's going to happen on that thing. And it's really, you know, it's a really heavy wheel. And, you know, you spin that first five, and you're kind of like, a little bit deflated. The good thing about
that
spinning...
That was awesome, the five, by the way.
Yeah, the good thing about spinning a five is your chances of going over are very unlikely.
Yeah.
So when I hit the 90, I just went absolutely crazy, you know, because then her options are very low.
You know what's so sweet? You weren't even watching it. You're just like, I'm going to enjoy this moment. You're giving shout-outs to family.
Giving shout-outs to everybody.
And then all of a sudden, boom, you make it to 95. You take part in the showcase showdown. And then again, so close. What was it? You were your opponent was over by something like $67.
Yeah, it was like 60. Yeah, it was close to like $65 to $70. He was over, so he had just missed winning both showcase showdowns. And you know, he was super nice guy. He had already won a car during the day, and we just sort of got along. And you know, my enthusiasm shows like.
A little Gangnam Style,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah. You crushed it. So nice. You walked away with a Fiat as well as, hysterically, a trip to Canada, but it's the West Coast.
It'd be great if you have to fly down to L.A. and then fly up to Revelstoke for the trip.
And you filmed this in October, something like October 29. How did you keep the secret all this time and throughout the holidays?
Christmas and New Year's, yes. You're celebrating and having fun.
You know, you just have to keep it quiet, you know, as part of winning on a TV show. They don't want to ruin any of the excitement when they're going to air it. You know, and so keeping it quiet, and you never want to lose a prize or have anything come down to that. So, you know, you had to keep your mouth quiet and, you know, figure out the logistics of what's going to happen after.
Would they take it away if you actually talked about it before?
Yeah, well, it's in the contract that if you speak about it before that you can potentially lose your prize. It doesn't say for sure, but it does say that there's a big potential
for
it.
That's good.
And you do get taxed.
A little's a light term. Yeah, it's 37. It's a 37% tax on everything, so 30% federal and 7% California tax.
But you can claim a lot of that back, can't you, coming back as a Canadian?
You can try. I haven't sort of figured out the full logistics of that yet. Also haven't figured out the full logistics of paying for everything yet. That's sort of in the works. You know, they give you a month after your show air dates to figure out that sort of logistics. Right. So I have a bit of time to figure all that out.
Good problems to have. Okay, we want to continue this winning streak. Come on over.
Let's go.
Stephen Moores, you're going to play BT's version of Punch a Punch. And it's, we're changing it to sort of Poke a Bunch because we made it ourselves. So it doesn't quite hold up.
We have a budget.
We have a budget. So what you're going to do is, thanks. Great job, by the way. You're going to poke through. Michelle, get over here. Your girlfriend Michelle is here. And you're going to poke through, grab what's inside. You need to grab three of the car images before three X's to win.
Okay?
So let's see. Let's see. Here he goes.
Here we go.
Come on, Steven.
Do this one.
Can you do okay, now put your hand in and grab what's inside.
Okay.
Let's see what we have here. Michelle, you did a brilliant job with the shirts.
Okay, so we got one car.
A car!
One car! Okay, keep going. This is like a 67 Camaro? What? We don't have that kind of...
Oh, another one.
A 67 Camaro!
Matchy-matchy-poo.
Here we go.
Okay. This guy's got some luck on his side.
And another one.
A 67 Camaro!
Wait, it's Camaro with a K. Let's look outside. Your prize is there.
Here's what you've won, Stephen. A genuine 1967 Camaro. From...
Gorgeous Gold. You want to be seen in this? Well, it's no big deal. Forget the Fiat, my friend. You can put this pocket protector anywhere you want. The value of this prize is priceless because you won it here on BT. Yes, take that, Drew Carey. Beat that.
That's great.
Not as much fun as the show, right?
Exactly. You're the best, guys. Congratulations. Thank you for being here.
We had a great trip.
Can we dim the lights? I know I'm putting them on the spot. Apparently, this glows in the dark, you said, Michelle, yeah?
Yes.
Can we dim the lights?
We can try.
Okay, we're going to see if this works. Before we throw to Stella, ladies and gentlemen,
it's
he lights up any room. He walked away with a showcase showdown. And he wears shirts that glow in the dark.
Yes, look at those colors.
Stephen Morris, thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having us.
Oh, that was amazing.
Let's head over now to Stella. Stella?
No tax on it.